Welcome to Shenzhen. In little more than my lifetime, this former fishing village on the east bank of the Pearl River estuary in South China has transformed into a vibrant, bustling metropolis of over 13 million people. This is the place where dreams were made, ideas born, and people thrived. So how did it get here? What lies ahead? This is Xinhua Special. First, a brief history lesson. In 1980, Shenzhen, along with Xiamen, Zhuhai and Shantou, became the country's first special economic zones. This status meant they would test reforms that would open up the economy to foreign trade and investment. This new system was made possible thanks to reform and opening up. This colossal systematic undertaking was launched in 1978 by Deng Xiaoping. It not only transformed the way that China interacted with foreign countries, but also China itself. Fast forward to 2012, and reform and opening up took on a new lease of life under Xi Jinping, who elevated Shenzhen once again to the forefront of this policy. This week, Xi made his third visit to the city in 8 years to attend an event that marked the 40th anniversary of Shenzhen's Special Economic Zone. His trip follows the release of a plan that maps out the city's new role as a pilot demonstration area of socialism of China's characteristics, granting Shenzhen greater autonomy in the reform of important areas and key links. Over the past four decades, Shenzhen's GDP rose at an annual growth rate of over 20%. And its per capita GDP skyrocketed from just 606 yuan to 203,489 yuan. That's about $30,000. The city's success is as much to do with the migrant workers who flocked here as it is to the policies that supported the businesses that employed them. People like Wang Chunxian, who came here in 1982 to work at a toy factory.
那个时候的一个月工资已经有300多块了。最贵的那年代买最贵的就是电视、冰箱、洗衣机。我第一年就把这三件全部买回去了。Wang's
monthly salary was more than double her parents' earnings combined. The modern household appliances she bought and paid for were luxuries far beyond their reach. Eventually, she worked her way up from factory girl to general manager. Hers is just one of countless Shenzhen success stories.
深圳的特在，它给你的机会很多，只要你愿意去尝试，你愿意去努力，你就有机会。不管是哪个行业，都可以创造出一个奇迹出来。The
opportunities for workers translate into goods and products that reach all four corners of the globe. Last year alone, the city's import and export volume surpassed $430 billion, which is around 10% of China's total foreign trade. For comparison, four decades ago, it was less than $20 million. There are, on average, 8.5 influential high-tech companies per square kilometre in Shenzhen. The city is home to 8 Chinese companies listed on the Fortune 500, and nearly 300 overseas Fortune 500 enterprises have their offices here. There is a frenetic energy to Shenzhen. It feels like a place where things get done. Stuff like this self-driving car, which was designed here in Shenzhen. Looking ahead, the new generation of new and exciting ideas has support and room to grow. And I'm headed to meet one now. Over 60% of all desktop robotic arms in the world were made by Shenzhen Yuejiang Technology. That is an impressive achievement, even before you find out that the company is just 5 years old. Shrinking industrial robots down to this size means they have a multitude of applications, from medical procedures to educational tools. Shenzhen was key to the company's success, as its founder told me.
因为经过40年的发展呢，深圳已经逐步成为一个创业者的天堂。它具有比较完整的这个人才链、供应链、资金链。深圳还有一个非常好的一些这种创业的。 鼓励的政策。比如说我们在2015年刚刚创业的时候呢，在创业的第一年我们就拿到了深圳市政府的创新创业的一个补助100万，再加上它一个非常好的这种营商环境，非常完善的这种法律的这种制度，那为整个创业者的成长就做了一个保驾护航。
Back when Shenzhen Special Economic Zone was established, there were just two technicians, a tractor repairman and a vet. Today, there are nearly 2 million scientific and technological workers known as high-level talent. Shenzhen is a city of migrants, not only attracting people from across China, but the world too. Gary is the founder of a multi-language food delivery platform here in Shenzhen.He has lived and worked here for 13 years.
In Shenzhen, it seems that once you make a home here, you are a Shenzhen person. You're not an outsider. And I feel that everybody here feels that not only is it home, but together we're all going to work to make this just a really great, amazing city.
Shenzhen has proven that it can support change that benefits the whole country. And with the deadline to achieve moderate prosperity, the first of China's 2 centenary goals,just around the corner. Xi's visit comes against a backdrop of an end that marks a new beginning, as China embarks on building a modern socialist country by the middle of the century, the second of the two goals. It is in this next phase where Shenzhen will step up once again. At the 40th anniversary event, Xi reiterated China's resolve to continue reform and opening up as it targets bigger goals.
Today, we are here to gather together.庆祝深圳等经济特区建立40周年，总结经济特区建设经验，在更高起点上推进改革开放，动员全党全国全社会为乘势而上，开启全面建设社会主义现代化国家新征程，向第二个百年奋斗目标进军而团结奋进。
Shenzhen would not be the city it is today without reform and opening up. And the success of much of that policy is down to the people on the ground who took the opportunities available and ran with them. 4 decades on, and the economic zone has proven to be special in deeds as well as name. And rather than an exception, the Shenzhen model is expected to be the norm across China in another 40 years. I'll see you next time.